Let me get my excuses in immediately. This background, this rather distracting, cluttered background, is not the sort of place I would ever dream of filming something. Except this clip is not about what things look like. This clip is all about audio. I was absolutely desperate to try a little technique that I saw on a YouTube channel about locations within a house that acoustically are very, very good to do voiceover. So I've just given that a little trial. Let's break it down. I saw this on a channel called Booth Junkie. It's run by an American guy called Mike, who's a professional voiceover actor. And his channel is just dedicated to voiceover work at home. Tips, workflow, insights about that. So it's geared towards that. A mine of information if you're interested in audio. Obviously, it's quite specific to people who want to just do a lot of voiceover work, but a very charismatic guy, highly recommended. I'll leave a link in the description. Now, in previous clips, I've talked about the absolute importance of trying to minimize echo and reverb when you're recording voice, when you're recording any sort of dialogue. And that is encouraged by hard surfaces, hard floors, concrete floors, tiled floors, wooden floors, hard walls, especially when they're at right angles to each other and you're in a small area. All of those things promote the sound waves that your voice is. They will promote the kind of reflection back of those sound waves towards the microphone, and that's going to be the echo and the reverb that you really want to avoid, because it's really undesirable. So this location is very good because, one, I've got carpet below me. That really helps. So anything going towards the floor is much less likely to bounce back up. But much more importantly than that is the fact I'm facing into and very close to all this soft fabric, this irregular soft fabric that's going to do a fantastic job of breaking up those sound waves as they enter that area. And that's going to really almost reduce to nothing the chance of those sound waves reflecting back towards the microphone. It should make a big difference. Right, so let's talk about the equipment I've used. I've got it right behind me here. Let me talk you through it. It's a very simple setup, but I think it gets the job done nicely. So microphone wise, I'm going into the Samson C02 condenser mic, normally at my desk, but I've relocated it here for this purpose. I've got the pop shield in front of it, very important to protect against those plosives. I've got the mic and the pop shield on a light stand. In terms of a recording device, I'm using this Zoom H6 handy recorder. It has 4 XLR inputs. Obviously, the mic is connected to one of those inputs via this XLR cable. In terms of monitoring, I've plugged in my Sony MDR7506 headphones, which, when I found out were very popular with sound guys, I decided I'd follow them. And then the Zoom is just held in place with this Manfrotto super clamp with quite a small friction arm connecting the clamp and holding the recorder at a nice level where I can look down at the display. So that's the setup. Let's see what we can get done. Mr. Utterson the lawyer was a man of rugged countenance that was never lighted by a smile. Cold, scanty and embarrassed in discourse. Backward in sentiment. Lean, long, dusty, dreary and yet somehow lovable. At friendly meetings, and when the wine was to his taste, something eminently human beaconed from his eye. Something indeed which never found its way into his talk, but which spoke not only in these silent symbols of the after-dinner face, but more often and loudly in the acts of his life. He was austere with himself, drank gin when he was alone to mortify a taste for vintages, and though he enjoyed the theatre, had not crossed the doors of one for 20 years. But he had an approved tolerance for others, sometimes wondering almost with envy at the high pressure of spirits involved in their misdeeds, and in any extremity, inclined to help rather than reprove. "I incline to Cain's heresy," he used to say quaintly. "I let my brother go to the devil in his own way." In this character, it was frequently his fortune to be the last reputable acquaintance and the last good influence in the lives of downgoing men. And to such as these, so long as they came about his chambers, he never marked a shade of change in his demeanour.
So overall, I thought a fantastic result, really, for what is a very basic, simple sort of setup. You could be up and running within 60 seconds once you put the microphone and cabled in. In terms of equipment, I would not get too hung up about what I was using, because it's very much the budget end of equipment. That microphone, the Samson C02, I think you can get a pair. They usually come as a pair, two microphones for about £111, something like that, which is obviously not nothing. It's £111, but in terms of professional equipment, it's very much the budget end. You can spend 10 times as much and more on microphones. So the same goes for the Zoom H6, which I've used many, many times over the last few years. Four XLR inputs makes it very, very convenient. You can have up to four different microphones running into that and captured with quite good quality preamps, so a very good signal to noise ratio. Again, that's about £300+, something like that. So again, not to be sniffed at, but very much a kind of the budget end of professional equipment. I have no hesitation recommending that particular unit. So hopefully this has given you a couple of ideas, because you undoubtedly have something similar to this space, where you could consider doing a bit of voiceover if you were so inclined. So if this clip's given you an idea, given you a couple of insights, been useful, a like is always appreciated. If you've got 60 seconds, the clip on screen now gives you an idea how I came to realize just how important audio is in content creation. And if all you want to do is make better content, consider subscribing, because that's what this channel is all about.